हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू डॉक्टर अशोक महाडिक्स लेक्चर्स, स्टडीज मेड इजी। हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू मैनेजमेंट अकाउंट टेस्ट सीरीज। इस लेक्चर आई विल कवर एमसीक्यू टाइप ऑफ ऑब्जेक्टिव्स ऑफ चैप्टर 1, इंट्रोडक्शन टू मैनेजमेंट अकाउंटिंग। सो स्टूडेंट्स, लेट अस स्टार्ट। फर्स्ट, फाइनेंशियल अकाउंटिंग डील्स विद, यू आर गिवन 4 ऑप्शंस: डिटर्मिनेशन ऑफ कॉस्ट, डिटर्मिनेशन ऑफ प्रॉफिट, डिटर्मिनेशन ऑफ प्राइजेस, नन ऑफ द अबव। Students, you have been studying financial accounts since FYJC. We used to prepare trading P&L account to find out profit. So main objective of preparing final accounts under financial accounting is to determine profit. So correct answer is determination of profit. Second, financial accounting records only actual figures, budgeted figures, standard figures, all of the above. Students, financial accounting is historical accounting, that is, it records only actual figures. So answer is actual figures. Third, the use of management accounting is mandatory, compulsory, optional, all of the above. The answer is it is optional. There is no act or law which makes management account compulsory. So correct option is optional. Fourth, management accounting relates to, options are recording of accounting data, recording of cost data, presentation of accounting data, none of the above. Well students, management accounting relates to presentation of accounting data. Fifth, management accountant has to collect information, analyze information and evaluate information. So correct answer will be all of the above. 6. Management accountant has to, options are control performance, supervise performance, coordinate performance. The management accountant has to do all of them. So option 4, that is all of the above, is correct. 7th, management accounting information is generally prepared for managers, shareholders, creditors, governments. Well student, in first lecture of management accounting I told you that management accounting information is specially made for managers. This is a tool in the hands of managers which assess them to take correct decisions. So answer is managers. 8th, management accounting includes financial accounting data, cost accounting data, budgetary control data, all of the above. Well students, management accounting collects data from financial accounting as well as cost accounting as well as budgetary control. So the fourth option, all of the above, is correct because managers use all these information to assist it to take correct decisions. 9th, management accounting is, options are analytical, future oriented, dynamic, and fourth one is all of the above. Well, let me tell you, the answer is all of the above. Management accounting is nothing but analytical, future oriented, and dynamic in nature. So answer is all of the above. 10th, scope of management accounting involves marginal costing, decision making, budgetary control, all of the above. Well student, in theory chapter I had told you the scope of management accounting is very wide, so it includes all of the above. So answer is all of the above. 11th, scope of management accounting involves revaluation accounting, break-even analysis, inter-firm comparison. Well, it includes all these three. So the answer is all of the above. 12th, the function of management accounting includes collection of data, analysis of data, and presentation of data. Well, the correct answer is all of the above. 13th, the functions of management accounting includes controlling, reporting, coordinating, all of the above. Well, again, the functions of management includes all the three mentioned at the top. So the correct answer will be all of the above. 14th, the role of management accountant is, we have already seen that the management accountant has to collect information, evaluate information, and interpret the information. So correct answer will be all of the above. 15th, strategic information is used by senior management, middle management, lower management, all of the above. Well, student, before I tell you the answer, I will explain what is strategic information. The information which is used by senior managers or top level management is known as strategic information. They need this information to draft strategies. So correct answer for strategic information is used by is senior management. 16th, strategic information is required for, as I told you, strategic information is used by senior management, that is top level management, for drafting or planning long range plans. So answer will be long range planning. 17th, strategic information is obtained from, as I already told you, that the information can be generated internally, externally, as well as from both the sources. But since the strategic information is used by top level management for taking future decisions, not only depend upon internal, but they also use external sources to get strategic information. So answer is internal and external sources. 18th, tactical information is used by, options are top level management, middle level management, lower level management, and all of the above. Well, students, I already explained that strategic information is used by top level management, but tactical information is used by middle level management. So our answer will be middle level management. 19th, tactical information relates to, options are productivity, budgetary control, variance analysis, all of the above. Well, let me tell you that tactical information is used by middle level management, who are heads of either production department or costing department or analysis department. So the correct answer will be all of the above. 20th, tactical information is generated internally, generated externally, generated both internally as well as externally, and none of the above. Well, as I told you, the strategic information which is used by top level management is generated internally as well as externally, but tactical information which is used by middle level management is normally generated internally. So answer will be generated internally. Next, tactical information is relevant to, options are short term planning, medium term planning, short term and medium term planning, and long term planning. Well, as I told you, tactical information is used by middle level management. So it is used for short term as well as medium term planning. So the answer is short term and medium term planning. Next, tactical information is based on, options are quantitative measures, qualitative measures, both quantitative as well as qualitative measures, and none of the above. Well, as I already told you, that tactical information is used by managers, and this information is generated internally, so it concentrates more on quantitative measures. So answer will be quantitative measures. Next, operational information is used by lower level management, middle level management, top level management, none of the above. Well, students, before this we have seen that strategic information was used by top level management, tactical information was used by middle level management, and this operational information will be used by lower level management. So the answer is lower level management. 24th, operational information is obtained from internal source, external source, both internal as well as external source, none of the above. As I already told you that the strategic information was generated by internal as well as external sources, but tactical information and operational information both are generated internally by the organization. So answer is internal sources. 25th, operational information is, options are quantitative, qualitative, both quantitative as well as qualitative, and none of the above. Well, students, let me tell you, operational information as well as tactical informations are quantitative in nature. Only the strategic information is both quantitative as well as qualitative. So the answer for operational information is quantitative in nature. 26th, strategic information is needed for, as we already discussed, it is required by top level management for doing long range planning. So the answer will be long range planning. 27th, strategic information is used by, it is already discussed that it is used by top level managers. 28th, tactical information is required by, we have already discussed that it is required by middle level managers. 29th, operational information is required by, any guesses? As I already told you, strategic information by top level management, tactical information used by middle level management, and operational information is used by the lower level management, that is line managers. So answer will be line managers. 30th, the users of management accounting information are, well, this was discussed earlier, the management accounting is a tool in the hands of managers. So the information is generated specifically for the managers. 31st, management accounting reports are prepared quarterly, half yearly, annually, as and when required. Well, the answer is as and when required, because management accounting is a tool in the hands of management. So they may ask for reports whenever they require it. So the answer is as and when they are required. Let us see MCQ number 32. The focus of management accounting is on internal reporting, that is, it reports to the management. Thank you students for watching this video. Students, if you have liked today's video, click like button and don't forget to subscribe the channel. If you click the bell icon, you will get the early notification for my videos. Students, if you have any doubts or queries regarding today's video, do message us on our official Instagram account. The link is given below in the description. So students, we will meet in the next lecture. Thank you.